Good morning, Internet. Welcome back to the Doom Rat's Nest. I'm going to include the save file in the description, and that save file will be from this point. And mostly so, if you guys want to hop in and try different things, I'd be interested to see what you guys come up with. I think I can mop this water to let my polluted water flow. So, what's going on? This is all stabilized. Right now, we are running at 4.5 kilos. Obviously not nearly what this thing can run at, but I just wanted to get it stabilized. We're up to 700 degrees in here, which is why these rooms are occasionally flashing to steam to burn off a bit of excess heat. So that's great. There it is. Oh, nope, good, that flowed off. I think there's... Okay, this is flowing off. Perfect, that way I can start to deal with the water. Power-wise, my power grid is absolutely insane. We connected everything up over here, around here. I got rid of these generators. These are still here as a backup. And then it comes down here, over to here, and then into the big battery stack. So these are here as a backup. So we now have all the power. Gas-wise, we're pumping a kilo into this room, a kilo into the other base. But this is going to produce way more gas than that. Hence, these boys. Instead of trying to store the gas in a room, I'm going to store the gas on other planets. So you, we want to shoot to the water planet. We want to shoot to the gas planet, or the tree planet. We want to shoot to the ice planet. And you need some power. And you need some power. And you need some power. And we might as well send some over here. So, that's what we're going for. We're going to store the gas on the other planets. I like to keep an eye on this tile. That kind of tells me what the pressure in here is. It was at like 60. Then I built all these, they all hold 1,200 kilos of gas. So this one's just about full. I wanted it to be full first before I start shooting. Rad-wise, we're up to 3,000, so we're getting about 300 a cycle. Over here, this is settled in quite nicely. Yeah, maybe it's got a little bit too much. Somewhere between 0.07 and 0.08 is where the amount is right. Yeah, we'll set this up a little bit. Yeah, because we're not quite getting enough power, but are you active again? You're idle. Perfect. Yeah, so you're now pumping gas into here, which can then also help run everything. And that also means we have extra gas for you once we get enough in there. I kind of pumped out all the natural gas to send to the other planet because, you know, emergency power issues. Yeah, so as soon as this is done pumping, I'm going to start shooting rads and kind of see what the pressure does. And for that, let's crank these up. And I've also dumped a whole bunch of plastic over here. How much do I have? Yeah, we brought over 100 tons. So that's there. And I should have brought over plenty of steel and thermium, but we'll use copper, lead, all that kind of good stuff. Then we can start to ship some plastic in here and see what happens. I'm glad I looked at this. This auto sweeper is in a vacuum, so it's not exchanging heat. Yeah, it got a little warm. I think this cools down because it gets the sulfur in it. So yeah, we'll just leave that off for a bit. Eventually gas pressure will get down here. Something else will cool it down. Oh, those are all done. And let's turn you on. So yeah, you're collecting 300 a second, and I've got you set to shoot at 100. And then that will keep going up. We're shipping nuclear waste over here. So now, what to do with the water? That's a darn good question. Well, I know for sure I'm gonna need a pump. Alright, I'd love to use that volcano to boil it, but I think I'm just going to brute force steam room it and get the sand out. It's not like we don't have the power. There's something just satisfying when you're playing this game and you get to this ridiculous power level when you're like, oh, I just toss in another Aqua Tuner and a Tepidizer to go in an infinite warming cooling loop. These steam turbines I put in just to try to keep the temperature over here around 120, and I was worried about, like, oh, what do I gotta do to get them into a vacuum? It's like, well, no, I want this room full of natural gas, so I just cracked it open, built it solid, filled it full of water. And a couple layers of water, worked out great. Ooh, free steel. So yeah, once I get this water sorted, the idea is this is gonna warm this up, this is gonna cool this down, this is gonna warm that up. We'll dump in the water. The water will then turn to dirt and sand. This will sweep it up and this will dig it up. And then we can use some of these gas pipes to help warm this up as well. So we'll put in some radiant gas pipes. Because, you know, free heat, why not? Slap a steam turbine on top of it to try to keep it all in the reasonable temperature, and we're good to go. While they're building that, I was about to launch my rocket again. I don't have any diamond. So I think this system is finally past what it can do. So it's time to rip this up. We have rad bolts. So we're gonna move the diamond presses over to here. Now how? I mean, I can use the rad bolt joint plate. You can't build that over existing. Okay. Yeah, so if I just put that there, then I just point that down. Yeah, either way, I'm just trying to think of the automation, whether or not I can shoot both of these, and I really can't. So yeah, right here is fine. With so many things going on, I thought I'd come check this, and I think it's hitting the wall. Oh, you're hitting that piece. Okay. That we can deal with. I thought it was like hitting the switch or doing something weird. I just noticed like none of these have shot. And I'll crank this up to more than 100. I just want it to actually shoot. There we go, much better. All right, so you're up to 125. All those little details. And this will take a little... Why can that not be reached? I guess I need a ladder. So we'll get the diamond presses moved over here, then I can make diamond. Well, yeah, that's because I'm dumb. Let's do this. Put a ladder in there, and then my dudes can actually get to it. And let's do the piping. Dump some super coolant in, and then the water can flow across the top. Of some sort. Guess I need a pump in there as well. You know, sometimes you do stuff so long ago, you completely forget about it. At some point, I set all of this up to run off of this gas well. Yeah, that's now coming back to bite me. Luckily, I should be able to just do this rather quickly. I was looking over at my oil base. I'm like, oh, I'm running out of water. That's weird. Why am I running out of water? And it's like, I'm running out of water because I'm not pumping any. I mean, now that they're running on the wheel, this should start to do something. But yeah, we'll get some power put in for it. And glorious water is flowing again. Need one more. Boom, power. Now we're hooked up to the main grid. I added more gas generators over here. Plus we got the gas coming in from the other base. Okay. I was looking at my water tanks going, why are they almost empty? I mean, technically these are water positive if I burned all of the water. But only running these, this is going to be about a kilo of water I'm going to get out of this. Which is good, but 1 kilo is not the 8 that this oil monstrosity is going to use once I start burning it all. But we are starting to shoot. And I think this shoots more rads than gas gets pumped in. I don't know, this will keep going up. We're only up to 400. Well, I don't know how I did it. Somehow there's 10 kilos of thermium inside of here. Well, I guess we'll just dump all that. Actually, we'll dump it down here. So hopefully my dupes don't run through the radiation as much. But this gun is now starting to shoot over here at 27 kilos. Oh, and these are starting to run out. Perfect, that means we can crank this up even more. Actually, I want to test the plastic. Ew. Manufactured plastic. Set you to 1. And then I think you just put these together. And then I can turn it on. This is kind of curious. I haven't used a plastic rail like this. I think it should work. Let's see what happens. So we turn you on. And you are now set to let 1 kilo through. We turn you on. And we have 1 kilo of plastic. Yeah, plastic is not melting fast enough. Worried about that. So let's turn you off, which will then make the gas pressure in here higher. Well, that was annoying. Turning this off doesn't turn this off because it resets itself. So I had to break the wire. Now you should stop. Okay. And the oil's done coming through, which means now the gas pressure in here will go up. And hopefully this stuff will melt. And while I'm waiting for that plastic to get up to 150, let's turn this up. Actually, I suppose we can do that over here as well. We're just not running that one yet. And the plastic's coming up at a decent clip. I think what's gonna happen is as soon as this plastic melts, it turns into liquid naphtha, and then that should boil really fast. Because this plate is 550 degrees. A little bit faster. This has got to get to, what, 162? You, we can turn back on. Oh, and a save. I've got my saves set for every 5 cycles, but they do take a while this late in the game. Set naphtha. And done. Now we rehook you back up. Yeah, that's just not exchanging heat fast enough. Darn. So I've got to preheat the plastic. And if I start dumping water, liquid on that. Okay, I mean, it's heating up. Okay, so I've got to preheat the plastic to closer to 100 before it can go in there. That's going to be annoying. Oh, this is just about done. Okay, so I need to get the gases out of here. I need to get some liquid up here. Alright, that seems to be working. I limited this to 500. And now the plastic is melting. Because I've also got the liquid dripper going. I mean, that's just horrible on the game. What if I just set you to on? Yeah. Okay, that settles you out. Now, what do the liquids look like in here? Just all sorts of fun colors. Okay, and now that's holding steady at 25. I want that to start coming up. Oh god, I've got way too much. Stop. Alright, we want... and probably about that much supercoolant to go in up there. And the diamond presses are now active. We're getting 300 rad bolts a cycle. And then once I start sending more nuclear waste over here, that will do better. Alright. So I need to get the gases out of here. And we'll just do the door trick. This I don't actually need. I need a room. Or gas pump. And with that pumping out the air, I want to get a little bit of water just to stop the other stuff from outgassing. So do that. And that super coolant, we want to leave that where it is. Easiest way to get to water is probably reverse this. And that. There. Water. Oh, that was a mistake. I tried turning the plastic up to 1 kilo, and that's apparently too much. So now I gotta wait for this plastic to melt. And I think we'll set this to 0.75 and see if that works. I've never tried balancing a plastic melter like this, so it's all kind of experimentation. That should be just about to melt, and you almost down to a vacuum. There it goes. Yeah, that's not melting. And it's not far off, but looks like 0.5 is the limit for this. 0.5. And with that being down to a vacuum, we can start to turn this on. Now I'm just going to seal the whole thing in. Oh, I probably do need ladders. Alright, steam pressure appears to be high enough. How I want to do the automation. I got pressure and temperature, so need to keep the temperature up and the pressure up. Then maybe I needed another pressure sensor. Well, I've got one side of the pump working. I was able to get that in there diagonally. Oh, there's gonna be some dirt and sand I can't reach with this. Eh, it doesn't matter. So you need water. Otherwise, you won't turn on. Luckily, somebody left a pipe. And that's not directional. Back to the plastic, that's all melted again. Got me set back to 0.5. And it's melting. Here comes the water. Turn the tepidizer back on. At some point. Is it coming in at? Oh, it's coming in colder than. I mean, once this turns on, I'll get warm water in here. So we'll get the pressure up. Oh, now we're starting to make dirt. I was hoping to make sand, but whatever, dirt will work. Thank you. Okay. For some reason, I thought maybe I didn't make these out of radiant pipe. But... good. How much water do I have? Not enough. It's going to be not submerged still. So I probably also need temp shift plates. That'll help. Alright. Finally have enough water in here. But now the tepidizer can actually turn on. And then they should start fighting. Load. 26. And you were set to 22. Oh, not submerged. Oh, damn it. I need more water. I thought I was at 350. I thought it was 350. Is it 400? Whatever it is, I gotta be close. There it is, 400. Okay. In the long list of things I'll probably forget, it's not 350, it's 400. Yeah, so now I'm just waiting for all this to warm up, and then I can start to get water out of the system. Over here, looks like half a kilo of plastic works. The pressure in here is starting to come up. So now this whole thing is full, and we are, what are you, out of range? Oh no, a dupe is coming to do it. Yeah, no, we never want a dupe to do that. I need a door. I definitely don't want my dupes running around up there. And you are... shooting, it looks like? You have zero rad bolts. Make sure I didn't screw this up. Nope, that all looks good. Oh! That's why. I need... yeah, I need another knock gate, and I need this to not be like that. This is why we check these things. I did the same thing over here too, didn't I? Pay attention to where your rad bolt things are. Oh, we got some dirt over there. There we go. Automation is now fixed. lock the dupes out of here. We're shooting gas, we're making gas, we're making steam. Thank you all very much for watching. These big projects take a while, and now I can start focusing on getting to other planets. And I hope you all just have a wonderful day, and we'll see you next time.